Worcester, Mass. Site of second round action as the madness continues on CBS. Our first game coming to you from the Syracuse bracket. It's the ACC versus the Big East. NC State and UConn. The bracket. The winner of this game advances to take on the winner of Wisconsin and Bucknell. Hi, everybody. I'm Gus Johnson along with my partner, Len Elmore. Lenny, break this one down for us.
Well, it's upset weekend. We've got a young but tournament-tested UConn Husky team trying to defend their national championship against a 10 seed that's experienced in the Wolfpack of NC State. Can it happen again?
All right, let's take a look at the starting lineups. Herb Sindek in his ninth season as the head coach at NC State. He has 421 seasons under his belt. His best player, Julius Hodge. What a tremendous performance in their opening round win against Charlotte. Jim Calhoun, two-time national champion coach, and he brings the Huskies into this game with a 23-7 record. Charlie Villanueva, sensational performance in their first round victory over the University of Central Florida. We have three terrific officials calling this game today: Curtis Shaw, Ed Hightower, and Steve Olson. This game is brought to you in high-definition television by Harris Corporation, the world leader in broadcast systems for high-definition TV. And Julius Hodge, the young man from Harlem, New York, controls the tip, and here comes NC State.
Well, you see UConn in a man-to-man. They're going to be tested because this Princeton-style offense likes to spread you out, look for threes, and obviously if you're playing for the three, get ahead of the line of ball, they're going back door.
Brackman pull up 17-footer, short. Williams with a rebound.
You know, Gus, we talk about a young team. We got three sophomores and a freshman in this UConn starting lineup. Many of them have experience from last year's national championship, but nevertheless, they are young.
Fourth overall meeting between these two teams. Nice. Back pass, Villanueva to Boone, and a whistle and foul inside. Offensive foul coming up against Connecticut. And the keys to the game.
Well, obviously State has got to keep that big front line, active front line of UConn off the glass and try to get second-hand shots of their own. But the bottom line is, with UConn, you've got to play above the rim. They lead the nation in blocks, lead the nation in rebound margins. And we had a chance to watch them the other day against Central Florida. Just tremendous, particularly on the defensive end and thwarting shots.
NC State coming off a 75-63 win over Charlotte. In that game, they were down by as many as 14, 12 at halftime, but in the second half, Herb Sindek put Cameron Bennerman on Brendan Plavik, who had 5 threes in the first half, shut him down. Plavik 0-for-3, and NC State holding Charlotte to 27% shooting. Here's Eftimov inside, lays it up and in.
Well, although they recognize UConn's penchant for blocking shots, NC State nevertheless looking to challenge the big men.
Baseline jump shot, Rudy Gay, and air ball. Bennerman with the rebound. Here come the Wolfpack out of the ACC. Julius Hodge. Backdoor, Eftimov pinned on the glass by Villanueva. Wow!
Eftimov looking for a goaltender, believing it, that was pinned on the downward flight.
Boom. Reversal. Denham Brown. And Atsur has the rebound. Back door, Hodge to the bucket. Won't stay down.
Boy, that was tough luck, but you see when Rudy Gay goes above the line of ball, NC State definitely going back door on him.
And Marcus Williams rises and knocks down his first shot of the game. Williams playing with the tender ankle, turned it in the first round against the University of Central Florida.
Because he is so key to this Husky attack, because he's the only natural point guard they have. And also because he's been tremendous, averaging almost 9 assists per game, as well as putting the ball in the basket.
Bennerman straight away, pure. Bennerman. 12 points for Cameron Bennerman in the opening round, but his defense was spectacular. Great athlete. Let's take a look at what happened to Marcus Williams the other day.
Well, again, driving to the basket to watch and see that right ankle turn. And not only was it painful for Marcus Williams, but I think Jim Calhoun had his heart in his mouth, recognizing that if Williams went down, didn't really have any serviceable backup point guard.
Rudy Gay picked up a foul, and the numbers for Marcus Williams, 8 assists per game. Only a sophomore from Los Angeles, California. Julius Hodge, F to Mob, ball fake, gets to the basket, contested by Boone.
And you'll see Josh Boone come over from the weak side every time, and it makes it difficult.
Villanueva, reverse layup, no. Gets it back, no. Once again, yes. Charlie Villanueva, 22.7 rebounds on 9 of 13 shooting in 32 minutes against Central Florida.
And again, we have an opportunity on both ends to see UConn playing above the rim, not only with the blocks, but the second chance opportunity.
Bennerman travels.
Well, Charlie Villanueva has been absolutely terrific, averaging about 17 points a game during the absence of Rashad Anderson, and that really boosted his level of play, and he's been playing terrifically since. You mentioned the numbers that he had yesterday, and over the course of the last 10 games, I'm sorry, 8 games before coming into yesterday, he was averaging 16 points and 10 rebounds.
He's got 4 rebounds and a block shot already. Gay, the freshman, now tipped up and in by Boone, but this will be interference. 15:57 to play in the first half. We're all tied up at 4. Welcome back, and Lenny, it's been an up and down tournament so far for the Big East.
Well, early departures for 3 of the 4 Big East heavyweights, and UConn the only heavyweight standing, but you got a couple of middleweights who are up and coming in West Virginia and Villanova. And West Virginia, that win yesterday, unbelievable, double overtime. Again, I always felt that because of their perimeter game, they would give Wake Forest, a team that has difficulty defending the perimeter, would give them a lot of trouble.
Tie game here. 15 minutes and 49 seconds remaining in the first half. NC State, UConn. Matsur, Eftimov with it now. Brackman, Bitterman, Hodge.
Again, you look at the open paint right there, giving the Cutters room to maneuver. But UConn, again, with pretty good defense this time, forces the jump shot.
Williams off the dribble, lost it, out of bounds. And it goes off of his knee. NC State gets it again.
Boy, Atsur, very, very deceptive. He doesn't look like he's got quick feet, but he's also got quick hands. And that time, just able to get a hand in and strip Williams on the drive. And that's going to be a tough matchup for Injun Atsur. Marcus Williams, again, playing with an awful lot of confidence and a lot of desire to get into that paint and create opportunities for his big front line.
Engin, a sophomore from Istanbul, Turkey, and he can really shoot the basketball, especially on the road. Hodge. 10 on the shot clock, pick and roll. Hodge turns the corner. Bitterman across the lane, ball fake, stolen away. Williams. In transition, nice deal to Boone, stolen by Eftimov. He's got Hodge with him.
You see that hesitation right there. That's where the block shot comes into play. UConn has blocked the number of shots already, and that's the intimidation as Eftimov had to turn and look and locate the defenders before he took a shot.
3 turnovers for NC State. Denham Brown off the mark. Now, when you're playing against a shot blocker, what's the best way to attack him?
Close the room between you and the shot blocker. Get into his chest, into his body, because shot blockers like to have a little bit of room and allow them to go up and get the ball without making contact.
So you drive it right at him, Len?
Absolutely.
Hodge on the baseline. Ed Hightower making the call. Looks like a foul coming up against Connecticut.
You know, block shots is such a powerful weapon on the defensive end. Obviously, last year with Emeka Okafor, it allowed UConn to do so many things defensively, and it tells in their field goal percentage defense. They hold opponents to about 38%, and the three-point D, they're doing a pretty good job defending closely on the perimeter because they know they have that eraser in the back in the event that a guy gets beyond it.
UConn has led the country in block shots four consecutive years. Okafor, 2 years. Eftimov downtown, no. Rackman attacking the goal, and he commits the foul. Meanwhile, Rudy Gay picked up his second foul for Connecticut.
Well, on this shot, you take a look right here. Wide open three. And look at Brackman come out of the right side of your screen. You know, that's his game. He's an energy guy. He took a shot at the gap and maybe trying to get a dunk off of the miss. Maybe energize his team a little bit.
Boone, double team. Reversal. Williams drives. Pulls up. High arc goes down.
That's what Williams has done. Made himself more effective as a distributor. He's become much more of a threat, particularly in the mid-range.
Eftimov, quick turn on the baseline. Hilton Armstrong in. Tries to lay it up, and a whistle and foul. He picks one up. And Connecticut, take a look at some of their numbers on the year.
Well, again, it's all about defense and rebounding for Jim Calhoun's teams, and you look at them in the top three in major categories. And then the assists per game, that's Marcus Williams right there. His improvement has really helped this team emerge as a pretty solid offensive team as well, averaging about 78 points a game.
So Eftimov picks up his second foul. He has to sit. He's one of five. Anderson. Ball batted around, Axel with the rebound.
Well, they really missed the shot, Anderson's consistency along the perimeter.
Hodge lays it up. Julius Hodge so dangerous when he gets the ball from the free throw line down. Williams crossover, 15-footer. Boone is there for the tip-in.
And that's UConn basketball, right back at you, even after a make. Push it up the floor, get your big men down the floor. In a broken floor situation where the defense isn't set, there are a lot of opportunities. And again, confident shooters because they know they have guys like Josh Boone that will go get the miss.
Gavin Grant, a freshman from the Bronx, Jordan Collins in. Here's Collins playing with the tender shoulder, and he throws it into the backcourt. Grant chases it down, and that is a turnover. CBS Sportsline keeps you on top of all the men's NCAA tournament action. Get real-time bracket updates and expert picks for each and every second-round game. It's all at CBSSportsLine.com. Ryan Thompson in the game. He moves to the off-guard position with Williams, Villanueva, Armstrong, and Anderson. Here's Charlie going to work. Jump hook, in and out. Grant with the rebound.
Boy, both of these rims a little bit tight. There have been balls by both teams that have been inside the rim and done everything but go down.
Collins pops out. Great look, too strong. NC State 3 of 11 from the field. Connecticut 4 of 13. Anderson with the step, wraps it around. Thompson there.
Anderson expected Charlie Villanueva to be there to fill in that gap on the drive.
Nine to shoot for Williams. Thompson, lefty jump shot. Atsour, another rebound.
Good job by NC State again. Really guarding the post, forcing UConn to swing the ball side to side, looking for perimeter shots and not getting anything on the block.
Atsour with three rebounds. Collins again. This time he hits it for three.
Well, that's Jordan Collins. Even though he's 6'10", 43% from beyond the arc, he's the guy that keeps the opponent's big man honest because he'll pull him out.
Armstrong turning. Atsour, another steal. He's on the rake and take. Grant travels. 10:38 to play. First half, NC State up by a point. The real good-looking guy sitting next to Jim Calhoun is George Blaney. And Coach Blaney is very familiar with the Worcester area, played and coached at Holy Cross, scored 1,000 points for the Crusaders, and also coached there for 22 seasons, led them to 3 NCAA tournaments, had 7 20-win seasons before leaving to go to Seton Hall. 9-8, North Carolina State with the lead. Connecticut shooting 4 of 14, 28% from the field. Here's Williams. Thompson. The kick out, Villanueva, rise and fire, and hit.
Well, Charlie Villanueva has really stepped up his game and developed that three-point shot. You know, it's taken a while for him to fulfill that promise that everyone had for him when he entered UConn, but he is definitely beginning to fulfill that potential. Second team all Big East, 11 double-doubles on the regular season.
Matsur, quick fire. Tapped out of bounds, and this one goes against Connecticut. Rashad Anderson tipping it out of bounds. Now Denham Brown checks back in, and he replaces Thompson. Julius Hodge, Elian Eftimov back in the game. Gavin Grant and Collins head to the bench.
And a lot of patience. Eftimov is a key guy. He's the passer, whether it's a low post or the high post, looking for cutters and jump shooters.
That one short. Levi Watkins. Villanueva, nice look to Boone, who pounds it down. Villanueva has become a terrific passer.
Well, he's just become a multi-dimensional player. Again, when he first got to UConn, having difficulty understanding the system, really thought that scoring was the way he was going to make his reputation.
Atzor can't lay it down on the backdoor cut. Here comes Williams, the lob. Charlie Villanueva can't hold on. And Julius Hodge the other way. Betterman, quick release. Count it.
3 points.
Cameron Betterman, such a terrific athlete. The defense he put on Charlotte in the second half was classic. Brendan Klavik had no room not only to shoot, but to even catch the ball. He was 0 for 3, no points in the second half.
Right now, Betterman doing a pretty decent job. Denham Brown hasn't scored, and he's a guy to rely on the perimeter.
Villanueva to the bucket. Beautifully done. How simple can it get for Charlie Villanueva from Brooklyn, New York?
And he's got Ilian Eftimov really puzzled. As Eftimov plays him for the drive, Villanueva hits the three. Plays him for the three, and Charlie's able to drive on him.
7.6 rebounds for Villanueva with the steal, one-hand pass stolen. Eftimov, Bitterman, Cameron pulls up off the dribble.
Oh!
Villanueva there, bats it to Anderson.
Charlie got bailed out on that one. The one-hand pass is a no-no. You know, you got to be more careful with the ball.
Tipped again at Soar. He's got Hodge. Nice bounce pass. Julius can't lay it in. NC State has missed a number of layups so far in the first half. Anderson, got it.
Well, again, in that exchange, the one thing you saw was NC State, they pride themselves on deflections. That's how Herb Sendek measures the defensive intensity of his team. They got their hands on a couple balls, created turnovers, but not able to convert. In UConn, you can't give them too many chances.
And Hodge fouled going to the basket. Connecticut has hit its last four shots and leads 17-12. All right, a look at the game summary. Connecticut shooting 44%. NC State has had opportunities, but they've missed some shots at close range. And right now, Lenny, UConn on a 9-3 run.
Well, they're on a 9-3 run, but they've turned the ball over 9 times. NC State only 4 points off those 9 turnovers, not doing a good enough job in converting the opportunities. And you talk about the 28% that NC State is shooting. Even though UConn has credit for only one block, they've done a tremendous job of intimidating the NC State shooters when they get in the paint, forcing them to look, travel, throw the ball away, you name it.
So the winner here advances to Syracuse as Julius Hodge steps to the line, and check out his line in the opening round. 19 points, 9 assists, 7 rebounds. He was 8 of 12 from the field, 3 of 4 from the free throw line in 40 minutes. Turned it over twice.
But a slow start today, 1 of 3 from the field. And really not as involved offensively, not as dominant offensively as he was against Charlotte, but most of those numbers came in the second half, so he's got a lot of game to play.
Sammy Amzion, a walk-on, where's number 10, is in the game now at the point. Villanueva off the glass, though, and the rebound goes to NC State.
Well, again, another good defensive sequence by NC State. No penetration by UConn and an inability to get the ball inside.
Inside, Betterman, turnaround jump shot, no. Villanueva with the rebound.
Now, why is Betterman at 6'4 falling away, fading away, when he's got Amezian guarding him?
Amezian, 5'10. Brown double teamed on the sideline, leaves his feet. Amzion with a good look.
He got as excited as you did.
For that he shot. Doesn't even have his name on the back of his jersey. And a whistle and foul inside. All right, let's take a look at yesterday's shining moment.
Well, Mike Gansey, the 19 points in the 2 overtimes, just a gritty, gritty performance. And Tucker with UW-Milwaukee, they did a tremendous job coming back from an early deficit. And obviously Illinois, you know, that team so efficient offensively, and it's a hero every day for them. It might be Darren Williams one day, D. Brown another, James Augustine on yesterday. And Illinois obviously showing why they're the number one overall seed.
Denham Brown stripped away, loose, picked up. Thompson back in the game. 16 to shoot for Connecticut. Williams rises for 3 and rattles it home.
And that's
on the line, they call that a 2.
That's what makes Marcus Williams so valuable. Again, nothing's working right now. State packed in defensively, and the point guard has to be a threat. That's the dimension they didn't have as often with Talik Brown last year, although Talik Brown won a national championship.
Eftimov got the roll.
Eftimov.
Side Nelson, power dribble, pass. Ed Nelson.
Well, again, the ability to move the ball. There's a good head fake, gets head and shoulders past Charlie Villanueva. But finally, UConn able to get a straight entry pass in the post. And Ed Nelson, who transferred last year from Georgia Tech, sat out last year because of that transfer, was the ACC Rookie of the Year his freshman year. Finally getting a little more time and getting a chance to show why he was Rookie of the Year.
Largest lead of the game now for Connecticut, 21-16.
Yeah, that's some
Cedric
depth.
Simmons leaves and takes a seat. Rackman back in.
That's some depth for UConn. The fact that you can start Gabe Boone and Villanueva and then come off the bench with a guy's experience as Ed Nelson.
Hodge posting up Thompson, takes him across the lane.
Good help by UConn against Julius Hodge.
And that's a 3-second violation called against Julius Hodge.
This is what you call protecting your own. Ryan Thompson against one of the best players in college basketball. And look at Nelson and Villanueva swarm him to make him give up the ball. Excellent help defense.
Nasty bounce pass, stolen away by Bitterman. Not a very good job by Williams.
There's one weakness to Marcus Williams' game, it is his judgment.
And then they give up a 3 on the other end, as Atsour gets it to fall. 22-16 Connecticut. Make it 22-19.
Again, a nice job, NC State, really sagging inside, preventing straight entry passes.
Tend to shoot. Anderson takes a look at the clock, the lead-in 15-footer. Brackman comes up with the rebound, his first. And the freshman, Andrew Brackman, had a great game. 16 points, 6 rebounds in the opening round. Hodge. Ball kicked, and will stay right here. Engenat-Sour, a terrific shooter on the road, gets one to fall. 3:02 to play in the first half. Connecticut up 22-19. Tonight on CBS, a fun-filled Florida beach is invaded by college co-eds and killer sharks. The OC, Shannon Lucio, stars in the world premiere of Spring Break Shark Attack tonight at 9, 8 central on CBS. 3:02 to play in the first half, 22-19. Connecticut with the lead. Cameron Bennerman, Andrew Brackman, Lillian Eftimov, Julius Hodge, and Engenat-Sour. Here's Hodge, not a three-point shooter.
In fact, coming into this game is 1-12 in his career in NCAA tournament games with regard to the three-point line.
Inside at Sour, make that Eftimov, has it blocked by Boone. Williams the other way, hard dribble down the lane, and draws a foul.
Well, Charlie Villanueva again picking up where he left off in the last game, 3 of 7 from the field, and again showing an outside bit of range and then some inside dominance as he continues and perseveres on that backboard on the missed shot. But again, we talked so much about his improvement. And coming into this tournament, 16 points, 10 rebounds in his last 8 games. So he is really starting to play the way Charlie Villanueva was expected to play.
Tonight on 60 Minutes, the story of a big gun that can kill a man from a mile away. Where did Osama buy so many? Well, right here in the U.S. The story tonight on 60 Minutes. Marcus Williams with 7 points, 2 rebounds, and an assist. 24-19, Connecticut.
Marcus Williams really asserting himself offensively. 1 of 7 against Central Florida today, 3 of 4 from the field, plus the 2 free throws.
Williams, though, has 5 turnovers.
That's where that judgment part comes in.
And a foul. Cameron Bennerman beating Denham Brown back door. Don't forget, coming up at halftime, Greg Gumbel, Clark Kellogg, and Seth Davis will take a look at Wake Forest and West Virginia. Terrific game last night, double overtime. Coach K close to the record. And they will also have a Naismith update. 2:10 to play first half. 24-19, Connecticut.
Look at Anderson battling Julius Hodge on the post. Again, good defense on the perimeter by UConn. Good ball pressure.
And the Wolfpack turn it over. Collins throws it away. 8 turnover in the first half for NC State.
And the ability to block shots in the middle allow the UConn Huskies to feel comfortable in really pressuring the ball, knowing that people blowing by them are going to meet with the big men on the front line. And that ball pressure pays dividends.
So NC State is shooting 30% from the field. They've turned it over 8 times. Charlie Villanueva back in the game. Denham Brown fumbles it away.
Another UConn turnover. NC State, if they could get more efficient in converting those turnovers, then close this lead.
11 turnovers for UConn. Here's Hodge. Straight right here. Collins for 3. Count it.
As I mentioned before, you got to play Jordan Collins at 6'10 beyond the three-point arc. Josh Boone just not comfortable playing that far away from the basket on defense.
Collins missed the opening round game because of that shoulder injury. And there's Rashawn Anderson, who's really fought this year to be on the floor this afternoon. He missed 7 games with a staph infection that really got serious. He was in intensive care for a couple of days. It affected his lungs, but he's back now. Came back in the Big East tournament. Brackman, Villanueva with another rebound and a whistle. Timeout called by UConn. 41.4 remaining in the first half. Connecticut with a 27-22 lead. All right, welcome back to Worcester, and some of the high seeds have taken it on the chin in this tournament.
Well, it just goes to show you that the big names and more traditional programs have got nothing over the upstarts, and a lot of young men these days are going places where they can play right away, where they can be on television, and now they know they can have impact.
Anderson has that one partially blocked by Brackman. Here comes Aksur along with Julius Hodge in the backcourt. Binnerman, Collins, and Brackman at a timeout, 19.2 to go in the first half. Connecticut with a 27-22 lead. Seconds to go in the first half. Connecticut with the lead, NC State with the ball. Why did Herb Sindek call that timeout?
Well, it's an opportunity to close this 5-point lead to 2, and Ilian Eftimov, his best passer and probably best 3-point shooter, was on the bench. He had to find a way to get him in.
Shot clock turned off. Game clock at 14. Here's a high pick and roll. Hodge kicks it out. Binnerman, good look. Awesome coaching move by Sindek. And here comes Marcus Williams driving to the basket. The high floater goes down. And that's the end of the first half. Marcus Williams, 10 points. Connecticut with a 29-25 lead.
Well, again, you take a look at Marcus Williams pushing it up. He recognizes how much time he has. Nice crossover in the open floor. And then just takes it strong to the hole. Again, this is what you want your point guard to do. Time running out. He's got to create for himself or someone else.
That's the end of the first half. Our score, 29-25. CBS Sports, exclusive coverage of the NCAA Men's Basketball Championship will continue after this message and a word from your local station. Connecticut up at halftime. We'll return to Worcester after this message. And a word from your local station. You're watching CBS Sports, exclusive coverage of the NCAA Men's Basketball Championship. Welcome back to Worcester. Start of the second half. Connecticut with a 29-25 lead.
Well, NC State has been able to stay in this basketball game because of the ability to hit the three. And all season they've placed a heavy reliance on it. 8 per game is what they make. They've got 5 already.
NC State comes out in the zone to start the second half. And this is where Herb Sindek flourished yesterday as the head coach of the Wolfpack turnover. He made some adjustments at halftime after allowing Charlotte to shoot over 50% in the first half, and he held the 49ers to 27% shooting in the second half. Now the winner of this game will advance to Syracuse and the Sweet 16.
Again, a low-scoring game, and a lot of it has to do with the UConn defense keeping NC State out of the paint, forcing them to take those threes.
Julius Hodge for 3. Boone with the rebound.
And for UConn, the thing that's keeping them down are their turnovers.
Get him Brown. Eftimov. Aksur. Brackman. Binnerman. Hodge.
Again, UConn very content in keeping NC State outside the arc.
Eftimov from downtown.
Well, it's the penetration and kick. And NC State taking what the defense gives them. If UConn's going to keep them out of the paint, they better cover the shooters.
Williams, 10 points in the first half. He continues to drive the ball to the basket. 5 of 6 from the field.
Well, again, the UConn offensive scheme really depends heavily upon what the point guard's capable of doing. And Marcus Williams, with that added dimension of scoring capability, keeps the defenses honest.
Hodge, back door, Brackman, no call, gets it again, double pivot and pump, and he is fouled. Brackman, Lenny, is showing some great maturity to be a freshman in this tournament so far.
Well, he certainly has. In the last three games, he's averaged 15 points a game, shooting close to 50%.
Two shots.
And he's just shown an aggressiveness around the basket. We saw in the first half, he got a foul trying to crash the boards, and he jumped on the back of a couple of Huskies. But that's what they need, that type of energy.
Near the end of today's game, we will select the Chevrolet player of the game from each team to honor their determination and outstanding play. Chevrolet will make a $1,000 contribution to each school's general scholarship fund, Chevy and American Revolution. Andrew Brackman, also a very talented baseball player.
Yeah, number one prospect in the state of Ohio as a pitcher. And the question was at NC State, was he going to play basketball or baseball?
Knocked away, picked up, Hodge, four on one. Hodge, Bitterman. And NC State takes the lead. The zone causing Connecticut problems. And Jim Calhoun is about to ring Charlie Villanueva's neck.
Early in the second half, NC State has stormed back to take a one-point lead, and this is what angers Jim Calhoun. Charlie Villanueva has a clear out. He never sees a defender step up, and he makes a one-handed pass, a very lazy pass, and obviously NC State able to convert on the other end to take the lead. And really, you know, as a coach, it just drives you nuts when a guy has an easy opportunity and he makes it a hard one.
13 Connecticut turnovers, 13 NC State points off turnovers. Herb Sendek coming out playing zone in the second half, and it's caused Connecticut some problems. Williams to Villanueva, and this time he makes the right decision.
Well, on that one, they were playing man-to-man, the Wolfpack, and Marcus Williams took a little time to recognize it. And then did the best thing, again, a point guard can do, penetrate and draw.
Eftimov spins. Ball reversal. Atzur wide open.
Again, the three ball is working NC State's advantage.
Nice catch inside. Gay can't get it. Villanueva tapped it. And Gay finally gets it to fall, his first basket of the game. He was in early foul trouble, had to leave in the first half after he picked up his second.
And how precious is the ability to hit the offensive glass? You know, UConn just doing a nice job again, of, at least on the offensive end, erasing a lot of mistakes.
Here's Hodge. Brackman. Hodge off the dribble now. Bitterman. Villanueva with the rebound. Anderson with a good look. Rudy Gay there. Ball knocked out of bounds and we'll head the other way. 15:37 to play. Tie ball game. The winner of this game advances to the Sweet 16 at Syracuse, where they will take on the winner of Wisconsin Bucknell. Now the other side of the bracket, of the Austin bracket rather, Utah and Kentucky. Those two teams have already advanced to the Sweet 16. Our score here, tied 35 apiece. And we have some information to pass along. Steve Olsen, one of the officials, injured his knee, and he has been replaced by Jamie Lucky. Atsour, Brackman, Hodge, Eftema, Betterman for the Wolfpack. Betterman off the dribble, hard to the basket. Beautifully done.
And what NC State is doing now is continues to spread UConn out, looking for advantage situations. Betterman a little bit quicker than Rudy Gay and Rashad Anderson when he gets the opportunity on the perimeter.
Williams turns it over. Betterman on the move. Atsour.
Look how far Josh Boone is playing Eftimov as Eftimov now comes back to the high post.
Atsour inside the kick, Bitterman. 10 to shoot for Brackman. Drop step on the baseline, pump fake, and he draws a foul. Villanueva called for the foul, his second.
Now that time on that trip, Brackman in the paint, but what's happening, NC State trying to spread UConn out. And you look how far Rudy Gay is trying to play Betterman, and then just off the bounce takes him to the basket. And they really don't have a match for Cameron Betterman. If it's Rudy Gay, you know, he's a little too tall, maybe not as quick a foot. And Rashad Anderson, you know, with his injury, hasn't been able to stay up with the guys on the perimeter as they try to take him off the bounce.
Herb Sindek making great adjustments in this tournament so far.
And then on the last trip, obviously they find a one-on-one post-up situation. First half, really didn't have any luck in the paint, but the second half now, NC State trying to find ways to draw fouls.
Williams down the lane. Josh Boone. Cut off. Turn. Loose ball. Betterman had a hand on it and a foul. Connecticut Land looks confused on offense right now.
Well, to a certain extent they are, but Josh Boone has got to realize the ball goes inside, the peelback occurs. You take a look right there as Atsour steps up to Boone. Boone then turns the other way and he finds himself triple teamed. You know, Josh Boone is a terrific player, but he's never really been a skilled post-up player with his back to the basket, at least not yet. So when he gets the ball down low and there's help coming, he does have a bit of difficulty.
NC State so patient on offense. Running this Princeton system, making Connecticut work for 30 of the 35 seconds on the shot clock. Off the turnover, Gay to the basket, draws a foul. Don't miss a minute of March Madness. Get live video to all games outside of your viewing area. Watch live team press conferences and access live archives of games you've missed. Get NCAA March Madness on demand only at NCAAsports.com or CSTV.com. Rudy Gay, freshman from Baltimore. Jim Calhoun told us a couple of days ago that Rudy has the potential to be the next great player at Connecticut. And they've had some great ones.
And although he's a freshman, he still, on that last foul, had an opportunity to finish and really just threw the ball up against the glass. And here on the free throws, he misses the first one. That's going to be the difference between being very good and being great. The ability to execute in the toughest of situations.
Four ties, five lead changes in this game. NC State with a 39-36 lead.
Betterman really calling for it against Thompson.
Drops the floater. And Williams has the rebound. Williams, a lefty, knocked away from behind as Betterman hustles back up the floor. And the big guys for UConn not having as good a day today as in the first round.
Well, again, Villanueva, the only one really from the field having any kind of success. You know, the offensive rebounds have helped a little bit, but there's really not much room to get the ball to the big guys. And Marcus Williams, again, the next best thing when he gets in the paint is for him to score.
Marcus, 6 of 7 from the field, 14 points. He's led the way for Connecticut, 39-38, under 13 to go.
And now this crowd gets in the game. And a lot of UConn fans here, they have essentially sat on their hands for most of this game. And a really good amount of Vermont fans here are just taking it all in, awaiting the second game, Vermont against Michigan State.
Six to shoot. Hodge has to hurry inside. Eptimov rejected by Boone. It didn't touch the iron. Shot clock violation.
Big play by Josh Boone. Again, we mentioned it before, his ability to come from the weak side and to help out really allows his teammates to play tough defense along the perimeter. You saw Boone right there. Got just enough of it to cause a shot clock violation.
Gay, off balance shot, a brick.
Rudy Gay really has to stop looking for that jump shot, start asserting himself down low and trying to take people off the bounce and elevate.
Rackman fouled inside. NC State with great floor spacing, so much room when their guards come off screens to get the ball down the lane as Nelson picks up his first foul. Fourth team foul against Connecticut here in the second half. Rashad Anderson checks in, replaces Rudy Gay. And Coach Calhoun will have a talk with his talented freshman.
Well, Jim Calhoun is searching for the right defensive combination. They're not having that much trouble scoring. It's about turnovers, but really they got to be able to stop somebody.
Williams the other way. Pulls up in the paint. Hodge, fair, and a foul. 11:52 to go, 1-point game in Worcester. Herb Sindek and the NC State Wolfpack with a 1-point lead, and Coach Sindek has done a tremendous job slowing this game down and keeping Connecticut off balance. He's got his number one fan in attendance, his wife Melanie. Also, his three daughters are here, Kelly, Catherine, and Kristen.
Look at the high screen there, trying to be set by Eftimov, and Hodge kind of waves it off. But NC State extending their offense even further, creating more spacing, looking to get isolations in one-on-one.
Hodge fouled by Gay. That's his third. Julius Hodge, not a big guy, not a fast guy, but knows how to play the game.
Well, you can see right now, this is the experience against youth. The senior against the freshman, down low in the block. And that's exactly what NC State wants to do. Isolate one-on-one situations, test the defender.
Julius Hodge, the only active player in college basketball with 1,900 points, 700 rebounds, and 400 assists. Throw good.
And Jim Boeheim recognizing, one, that Rudy Gay's got three fouls, but just as importantly, needs a more experienced player out there on the defensive end.
Denham Brown, Anderson, Boone.
Sorry, Jim Calhoun.
Villanueva and Williams. Anderson on the baseline, forced it up. Eftimov taps it to himself. And now Connecticut comes back and has to play at least 30 seconds of defense.
UConn just not getting any kind of offensive push. If Marcus Williams isn't penetrating or pulling up for the mid-range, their offense is pretty stagnant right now.
Hodge posting again. Drop step, left hand up and in. Textbook offense for NC State. And Jim Calhoun needs a timeout. 10:39 to go. Biggest lead of the game for the Wolfpack. Connecticut with no rhythm so far. Let's take a conference call and look at the ACC.
Well, Wolfpack trying to keep pace. Obviously knowing Wake Forest lost yesterday. And, you know, they came in here as a 10 seed, but they were playing some of the best basketball that they played all season down the stretch. So that may be just kind of a mischaracterization of who they truly are at this point in time in the season. They're a much better team than a 10 seed.
Boone fouled inside.
But then again, they got a lot of company. You got a lot of 10, 11s winning games.
Al Williams inbounding it. Foul was called on Andrew Breckman. His second. Williams down the lane, and he draws contact.
And right now, Marcus Williams is all of the UConn offense. And again, I said their offense is stagnant. When he's not penetrating and pulling up for the mid-range, or when he's not getting into the paint and creating for himself, the offense is relatively stagnant. A lot of that is because NC State is sagging and allowing Williams to go one-on-one, and they're betting that he's not going to make it. And the other is, you don't have enough help on the perimeter for Marcus Williams. Rashad Anderson, Rudy Gay, none of them able to put down the perimeter jumper.
15 points, 2 assists for Marcus Williams, but he's turned it over 6 times. Now UConn will try to change the tempo defensively, picking up full court. Gay back in.
So they're trying to force NC State to take some time off the clock and take a quick shot.
Akhtemov in the corner for 3.
And NC State with a nice job of attacking that press and not standing pat.
Williams again down the lane. He can get there whenever he wants now.
And so you can see NC State is just allowing Williams to go one-on-one. They refuse to help because Williams is so adept at drawing the defenders and kicking off. NC State will live with Williams and trying to make him beat them.
He averages 8 assists per game. Rackman. And it's blocking. Looked like an offensive foul from here. But a blocking call against Anderson. And that's his second.
Rashad Anderson never really got to the baseline in time. Take a look right here. On the angle, you know, you got to beat the man to the spot and be in position in that type of block charge situation.
So NC State is in the bonus, shooting 1-1 at the 9:28 mark of the second half. 17 fouls now against Connecticut. Wolfpack at 3. And the first one good tonight on a new cold case. A housewife is murdered 20 years ago. Now new evidence reveals some unusual suspects. Don't miss a new cold case tonight on CBS. Let me correct myself. Marcus Williams is averaging 8.9 assists per game. And according to you, that means 9. You always get on me about that.
You gotta round it off. But he also leads the nation.
And Akhtemov fouling Williams. And that's his third fourth team foul against the Wolfpack. Rudy Gay yelling out zone. NC State in a 2-3. Williams penetrates. Off balance, tipped around. Atsour with it. NC State somehow gets it back. Atsour looked like he fell out of bounds with the ball. No foul was called.
And against his zone, Marcus Williams has to be sure not to take off-balance shots because they come off awkwardly. You see right there, Atsour had a little help out of bounds from Marcus Williams. Fortunately for UConn, no call.
Looking at how NC State is running this offense, Pete.
Look at the spread floor. Look at how much room. No one in the paint. Looking for cutters at the top. Penetration and kicks.
Atsour off balance. Julius Hodge there. Pete Carrill must be somewhere smiling because NC State is running this offense to perfection, leading at 49-42 with their largest lead of the game. Villanueva, a quick shot. That one partially blocked and out of bounds. Hodge may have gotten a hand on it.
Well, the offense NC State is running is Princeton principle. They don't get the ball to the high post guy nearly as often and doing the curls and the backdoor cuts as frequently, but certainly the principles are there.
Rudy Gay fouled.
Well, three-point shooting is really what's kept NC State in this game and actually given them the lead, and it's been the ability to penetrate, kick, to spread the floor, and exploit the inability of UConn to cover those shooters, particularly along the front line, where the big guys for UConn are very hesitant in going out there to cover jump shooters beyond the arc.
Rudy Gay at the line, Nelson comes in. Julius Hodge picked up his second foul, five team fouls against NC State.
You know, the Husky big men, they're so accustomed to staying around the basket, trying to get rebounds to help on penetration, that they usually come out late on the shooting.
Nelson with the offensive rebound. Anderson, rising fire. Way off the mark. Nelson, another offensive rebound.
And Ed Nelson's really giving this team a lift right now. Nothing that you can essentially look at in the stat sheet but for those offensive rebounds, but certainly his defense and his overall presence inside.
Pick and roll, Williams splits the D down the lane, the teardrop. Rebounded Hodge, outlet Bitterman, three on one. Here's Entomov spotting up, Brackman there, draws a foul. Wow. The freshman hustling on the offensive boards, and he will head to the line. Welcome back here in Worcester.
Well, you take a look at three-point field goal situation. That's what's gotten NC State the lead. And UConn's offense has slowed down. I mean, they're 1 of 8 in the last 4 minutes and 25 seconds. Only one field goal with that size. That's not going to get it.
So UConn, Lenny may be thinking about it right now, getting a little tight.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, they don't want to be the second number two seed to go down. I'm sure they watched television yesterday and saw that Wake Forest lost in overtime, double overtime. And you can tell. Again, by the way, the UConn Huskies are looking at each other, why they're wringing their hands in some instances. Jim Calhoun has got to find a way to admonish them when they make mistakes, but also build their confidence. This is still a young team, a freshman, a number of sophomores out there trying to lead this team, and they need confidence builders at every turn.
NC State 11 of 12 from the free throw line with their largest lead of the game. Here's Nelson. He's been an energizer to Williams. He's called. Nelson with the rebound, knocked away. And Soar had it. So the defending national champions are on the ropes. 7-10 to play in the second half. 51-43. NC State out of the ACC.
It's important for UConn not to get frustrated with this offense, to stick with defensive principles, string together some stops.
Hodge inside. Nelson there, and he bats it to Williams. Huskies need to hit a couple of buckets now. Williams inside. Nelson, great catch. He's fouled. And that will be the sixth team foul against NC State. 1-2 seed is already gone. Wake Forest, Oklahoma State takes on Southern Illinois today. And the Kentucky Wildcats are in the Sweet 16. Knocking off Cincinnati yesterday. Nelson. Williams, double clutch. Short, knocked out of bounds. We'll go the other way.
The problem with the UConn offense is they're just standing around. Marcus Williams gets the ball and everybody stands and watches him. And he's forced to take the shot. You take a look at the rebound right there. He called it off of Charlie Villanueva, but there are about three hands that touch that ball.
And Marcus Williams has missed his last four shots.
Well, he's got to be tired. He's got to handle the ball. He's got to get everybody involved in the offense. And then of late, he's been the offense. So he definitely has to be fatigued. Plus, he's got a tender right ankle.
We haven't heard from Charlie Villanueva, 9 points, 11 rebounds. But this is when Jim Calhoun needs him to dominate and not fade away. Brackman. Rebound goes to Entomov, and a new shot clock. And NC State just out-hustling Connecticut now.
And of course, right up off the bench comes Josh Boone. That rebound, offensive rebound by NC State, really got Calhoun's attention.
Hodge, great catch inside, and a foul. Villanueva fouling Julius Hodge.
Look at the struggles of that front line, starting front line for UConn. You know, none of them really involved. Charlie Villanueva in the first half had some success, but he's pretty much been invisible here in the second half as he goes back to the bench. And this is the sign of maturity. Charlie Villanueva, if he's going to be measured by growth, it's not just stats, it's maturity. And the bottom line is, when you get in crunch time, you've got to dig in deeper.
Julius Hodge. Wednesday on Survivor for one drive. It's a fight to stay in the game. They need the next win more than ever. Don't miss a new Survivor on a special night Wednesday on CBS. And this NC State team is playing like they need the next win to survive in advance, and they do, and they're playing like it. NC State on a 7-1 run. They've been in the 1-1 since 9 minutes and 28 seconds remained in the second half. Williams inside Nelson, and he banks it home. Nelson is the only guy aside from Williams playing with any energy and passion on this Connecticut team.
And he's playing with the will to win as opposed to the fear of losing. And that's been the problem for UConn, particularly their young players.
And Bennerman hits a three.
And you can see NC State feeling it now as Cameron Bennerman backpedals after hitting that shot.
Williams down the lane and a foul. So with 4 minutes and 59 seconds to go, Williams heads to the line. That's the seventh team foul against NC State.
Marcus Williams, you can see him talking to his teammates, trying to get them to come with him, particularly with attitude. I mean, some of these guys now seem, through their body language, not Ed Nelson, but the rest of them, they're almost resigned to the fact that they're losing.
Rackman picked up the foul, Williams. So let's take a look at what the last four national champs have done the year after.
Well, obviously, you tell UConn really wants to at least get back to the Final Four, but they're such a young team, and the odds of that happening against experienced teams like this grow slimmer and slimmer as they meet the higher level of competition. And even here in the second round, NC State's experience, patience, and poise has really hurt UConn.
And a foul called against Julius Hodge, trying to create space against Thompson, his third.
And experience is not a corner on making smart plays all the time. Julius Hodge, throughout the season, would have his moments when he just didn't do absolutely the smartest thing. And in some instances, winds up hurting his team. Right now, he's got a bit of a cushion, 9 points, so that play may not hurt them totally.
Villanueva back in the game, along with Rudy Gay, Thompson, and Nelson. Williams at the point. Inside, Nelson fires, gets it to go. This kid has been terrific off the bench for Connecticut.
And it bears repeating, remember, Ed Nelson was in the ACC his freshman year, rookie of the year, before transferring to UConn. And he's got 7 points and 3 rebounds right now. And again, he's given them a lot of energy and a solid low post presence to kind of complement what Marcus Williams has done throughout this game.
He's played with a sense of urgency. 4:08 to go. Connecticut has to dig in on defense. Inside. And that is a foul coming up. Evtemov going back door.
You hate to pick on the kid, but Charlie Villanueva once again broke down defensively. And that really breaks your heart if you're a Husky player. Everybody digs in, does their job, and then one guy lets up and allows a backdoor cut or a rub off of a screen, and they get to the line.
Finally a missed free throw for NC State. And these are the games coming up next, Nova and Florida, which should be a terrific game, 4-5. NC State today 13-15 at the line. Evtemov gets the second, 57-49.
try to take the ball out of Marcus Williams' hands. Right now, he is the only threat on the perimeter.
Give it away, the jump hook, got it, and the foul. Charlie Villanueva cuts it to six, 3:49 to play. Here we go in Worcester. Let's take a look at as State Farm covers the court with the tournament summary.
Well, again, we talked about the Wake Forest loss and the West Virginia win. Wake Forest with a lot of problems guarding that perimeter. And West Virginia normally likes to control that tempo, 111 points. Wow, their noses must be bleeding. That's Haiti Heights.
NC State's 11-point lead has been cut to five on a 7-1 Connecticut run. Villanueva checks out of the game.
And again, really the defensive team is on the floor for the UConn Huskies, as this is kind of their last stand right here, trying to dig in, string together some stops.
NC State still with a bitter taste in their mouths after last year losing 75-73 to Vandy, leading the game down the stretch, but unable to hold on.
And again, that's why we talk about the experience of NC State. Got the senior Julius Hodge, some juniors out there who've been tournament tested as well.
Rackman on the baseline, the freshman, no. Gay with the rebound. Connecticut can get even closer now.
Now, if there was ever a time Rudy Gay can be that second option to Marcus Williams.
Inside, boom, jams it down. 57-54, under three to go. And a timeout called by NC State. Herb Sendek feels this one slipping away. Let's check the CBS Sportsline stat of the game. 3-point field goals. NC State 5 of 10 in the first half. Second half 4 of 9. Connecticut 0 for 4. In the second half, get complete game stats at CBSSportsline.com. You have to think, though, that Connecticut has one three-pointer in them in the second half. They are the national champions.
But they may not need it. I mean, their game is predicated right now on in-the-paint play. Their problem is whether or not they can stop NC State without fouling. They're in the double bonus right now. The next Connecticut foul is two shots for NC State.
Hodge posting up. Draws a double. Brackman. Travel. Beautiful defense by UConn.
That's what it's all about. And on the last possession, they found a way to throw over the defense to Josh Boone. You know, before the break, I was mentioning Rudy Gay might really fit in that particular role, but Boone was the guy. And again, as long as NC State stays in the zone, look for UConn to exploit their athleticism.
Last year, NC State was up on Vanderbilt by 11 points with 3:45 to go, lost by two. They've been up by 11 today. And a foul inside.
And again, I talked about throwing over the defense. I thought they'd throw over the zone, but they'll throw over the man-to-man. And right here, Villanueva just gets position on Eftimov. And in Eftimov's attempt to try to knock the ball out of the air, he backs into Villanueva, contests the call. And UConn was 1-1, nevertheless.
So Eftimov fouls out with 11 points.
And boy, what a key loss for NC State. Eftimov, the guy who passes and shoots the three in that spread offense.
Tomorrow on CBS, skateboarding legend Tony Hawk is the latest victim on CSI Miami. Don't miss a new episode tomorrow at 10, 9 Central on CBS. So Ilian Eftimov takes a seat on the bench. He's replaced by Collins, who missed the first game with a shoulder injury. He dislocated his shoulder at the end of the season. Charlie Villanueva heads to the free throw line. Offensively, he's had a terrific game. Defensively, a poor one.
There's ways to make it up. And at least on the offensive end, you go to your strength. Let's go. Those big shots by Charlie.
57, 56.
And you see Jim Calhoun once again going offense, defense. Villanueva on the offense. Josh Boone in on the defense. Now with Jordan Collins in the game, he's got three-point range. He's just not as nifty with the ball as Ilian Eftimov.
NC State led this game 56-45 with 5:07 to go. Their largest lead at the moment was 11 points.
And what a job Ryan Thompson's asked to handle by guarding Julius Hodge. He doesn't get any help.
Williams the other way. Nelson, pump fake, flips it up, and he's tripped and fouled.
And if you notice again, UConn not even looking for a three-point shot. They believe that they can continue to go into the heart of the NC State defense, and that way they get an easier field goal. Recognizes they need to get points any way they can.
Nelson, a 67% free throw shooter. You have to love the way this Connecticut team has fought back. Jim Calhoun pulling the right strings, making substitutions on offense and defense, taking Villanueva out of the game when it's time to D up.
Right now, Rashad Anderson back in the game. He's going to be asked to guard Julius Hodge.
Lane violation coming up against NC State. So Nelson will shoot it once again. Nelson off the bench, 8 points.
Well, that's what this tournament is all about. You must capitalize on second opportunities.
Connecticut on a 13-3 run. They pulled to within one after trailing by 11 with 5:07 to go in the second half.
Again, a much more experienced Rashad Anderson guarding Julius Hodge man-to-man. Expect NC State to ride Julius.
Shades of 1 year ago for NC State, 59-58. All right, let's reset it for you. Both teams with two timeouts left. Both teams in the double bonus, 1:34 to go. NC State on top of Connecticut, 59-58. Charlie Villanueva sits. He's been a liability on the defensive end. Connecticut on a 13-3 run.
Well, right now, there's nothing complex about what NC State has to do. You got to get it to your playmaker, who honestly is Julius Hodge. Run some time off the clock. Get it to Hodge and hope that Hodge makes the play.
Hodge always likes to post up on the box. Bitterman looking to get it to him. Down the lane. Collins steps up. It's short. Bitterman with the rebound. And NC State has a new shot clock. Atsuo to the freshman. Oh! Brackman knocks down a big shot.
Marcus Williams took a chance trying to draw an offensive foul, and I'm not so sure he didn't do it. But once he went to the floor, watch here. Atsuo, that's an offensive foul, no call. It gives Atsuo an advantage, and Brackman does the rest. That is very surprising. That was an obvious call, obvious.
But Williams will go to the line. The foul called on Brackman. No, make that. Bennerman, his third. Williams perfect today. We've got more great basketball coming up next. Villanova, Florida, Southern Illinois, Oklahoma State, Iowa State, Carolina, and here Vermont, Michigan State. Williams again. Williams, a career-high 22 points. Now Charlie Villanueva checks back into the game, replaces Nelson. And Nelson gets a standing ovation from the UConn fans. He deserves it.
He certainly has. Again, brought energy, brought some muscle, played defense, everything that UConn needed to make this comeback.
Julius Hodge walks it into the front court.
Again,
Hodge back door at Sewell. Williams closed on him. Terrific defense by the sophomore. Bitterman turns a corner. Almost lost an edge and turned it over.
Again, UConn playing defense, able to get NC State to speed up just a little bit. They're very accustomed to playing nice and slow, getting you off balance and then exploding to their spots. That time they kind of revved it up a little bit and it worked against them.
Timeout called by NC State. It's a short one. NC State up by two. Connecticut with the ball. Both teams in the double bonus. NC State one timeout left. Connecticut with two. The winner advances to the Sweet 16 in Syracuse. So Nelson back in the game. He's got Williams. Anderson, a great three-point shooter. Villanueva, Rudy Gay. Shot clock turned off. Game clock at 25. Williams crosses over. Spins down the lane. The floater, no. Got it around Collins with the rebound. He lost it. Villanueva, and we're tied at 62. 12 seconds for Julius Hahn. Wolfpack has a timeout. Herb Sendek lets him play. Here's the man from Harlem. Up, got it! And the foul! What a sequence. 4.3 left.
Well, again, Marcus Williams gets the shot blocked, and then in a loose ball situation, Villanueva, right man in the right place. And on the other end, again, you give it to your best guy to make plays as Gay falls down.
And look at the NC State bench. Hodge, 16.6 assists, 12 points in the second half.
And again, you see the drive, a trip on Rudy Gay as he trips over Jordan Collins' feet. And that's two baskets now that NC State was able to make. As you see Julius Hodge kind of roaring right now. Those are two critical baskets NC State able to get based on UConn defenders hitting the deck.
So Julius Hodge will go to the line. And try to complete the conventional three-point play with 4.3 seconds left.
And if I'm UConn, regardless, make or miss, you've still got an opportunity to tie this game. I don't know if anybody should be shrugging their shoulders right now. If anything, think about executing on the other end, make or miss.
So Hodge will shoot. UConn 0 for 4 from the three-point line in the second half. And a timeout call. Herb Sendek calls the timeout to set the defense. 4.3 seconds left. 65-62. North Carolina State trying to knock off a second number two seed in this tournament. And the defending national champs. Last year they were in the same position, a similar position, up by 11 against Vanderbilt. Julius Hodge fouled out of the game. Vandy K back to win by two. Herb Sendek's wife, she can't even look.
Well, right now, if you're UConn Huskies, what you want to do, you have got to spread the floor. Get the ball inbounds. Make sure you get it inbounds to Marcus Williams. Spread the floor. And then you're going to have to allow Williams to try to do something to draw the defenders and get somebody a wide open three. And the only other thing you can do is if the long pass is available, at least the first pass to half court to someone like Rudy Gay or Rashad Anderson, you certainly want to hit that. But the safest bet is to get it in Williams' hands and let him push it up.
4.3 seconds left. Connecticut will have to go the length of the floor. Anderson, Gay, Williams, Villanueva, Thompson. They're 0 for 4 from the three-point line. in the second half. Here's Williams. He's got to hurry. Behind the back. Let's it go. No. And Connecticut falls. NC State knocks off the defending national champions 65-62.
What I tell you?
And this one was all about experience, Gus. It's about NC State being able to come from behind and then spread the floor, utilize the senior Julius Hodge, really run that Princeton-style offense to perfection as they got the younger, less experienced defending national champions in jeopardy several times down the floor in critical situations.
NC State wins it 65-62. The bracket, NC State advances. But the senior led the way for North Carolina State, Julius Hodge. A three-point play with 4.3 seconds left. And let's take a look at our Chevrolet players of the game. No surprise here. Julius Hodge, 17 points, six dimes. Ed Nelson off the bench, the only man alive for this Connecticut team at one point.
Yes.
65-62 for the man from Harlem. For Lenell Moore, this is Gus Johnson. Now let's go to New York and Greg Gumbel.
I love you, Mom. I love you.
Mom loves you too, guy. North Carolina State, a 65-62 winner over the defending national champions. NC State is into the Sweet 16. Underway right now, Villanova against Florida in Nashville. There are other games still to come. We'll send everyone off to Nashville, and we'll get you to the tip of your game, Oklahoma City. Your tip is coming up too. All of that after this word from your local station.